no sé cuál me voy. El ferro, el Porsche, la C3 o el Rolls Royce. El bote parqueado en San Croix, viviendo la vida como si se va a acabar hoy. Yo, tranquilo en la mía es que estoy. El Richard Zafiro, Dios más los bendiga. Mis hijos no nacen otros como Floyd. La baby le llegan los míos, al día no le falta nada. Las guaguas son negras, están todas blindadas. Tú ronca allá afuera, aquí tú no eres nada. Porque mi tiempo me vale dinero. No te asustes si te enseño todos los ceros. La vida me bendijo porque me mero. Soy mi jefe, so hago lo que yo quiero. Aquí arriba no llegan.
And a welcome to Citi Field, New York's National League Ballpark in Flushing, Queens. A good matchup here for you tonight between the St. Louis Cardinals and the New York Mets. It's Mets baseball next on the show. Rich Hill gets the ball for the Mets in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Well, when you think of Rich Hill, there's one thing you think of. Power curveball. Has one of the best left-handed curveballs in the game of baseball. He'll throw it early, he'll throw it often, and he'll throw it any time in the count. His velocity isn't that bad either. He can get it up to 93, 94, but when you walk up there in a box against Rich Hill, you have one thing in mind. Try to hit that curveball.
Tommy Edman is in to start things off as he looks at a ball to start the inning, 1-0.
First pitch, 7-10.
Now the pitch.
Hey.
Line, but speared on a hop, and the throw to first is in time, one gone. Now a chance to look at the starting nine for the visiting St. Louis Cardinals. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, you've really got to be able to appreciate the incredible talent of Paul Goldschmidt. He had over 20 runs batted in last month. Very consistent. A solid month, and I love watching him swing the bat. It looks like the focus and concentration is even better when he has runners in scoring position.
Paul Goldschmidt comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. The average sits at 286 here to start play. 24 home runs and 84 runs batted in. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Ball.
One out, nobody on. Lifted down the line and left. Here comes McNeil. He's through first and hustling for second. And now this will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
You can see that he was all over that pitch, yanking it down the line. They're lucky that thing bounced over the fence, because if it would have got lost in the corner out there, there's no telling how far he could have gotten.
So now to the plate, Tyler O'Neill hit hard toward the right side. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. And the run will score as the Cardinals are on the board first. It's 1-0.
Every manager and every pitcher in the league loves to play with an early lead, and they've got one here. Back-to-back doubles put them up by a run, with the opportunity to stretch the lead here with another dangerous hitter set to step up.
Here's Nolan Arenado as he'll wait out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. And there is our officiating crew in this one, calling balls and strikes, Mr. Freddie Ferguson.
You know, this is one of the guys behind the dish, Freddie Ferguson, Dan, that the rookies are going to have a tough time with. If you've played in the league for a little bit, you understand that he's got his own zone.
You touched on it, D-Roy. I think he rewards the veteran players, not only pitchers, but position players. He makes the younger players, he makes them earn their keep.
in the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Tried to backdoor him and lock him up with a curveball right there. Pretty good pitch, but he didn't quite get it to come back all the way to the corner. That's tough to do for most guys.
Line drive, base hit into the left center field gap. The run scores from second. It's a 2-0 ball game. And now three consecutive hits here in the top of inning number one, and these hometown fans are starting to wonder what's happening out there. Yadi Molina digging in now, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. And he misses with it, 1-1. Arenado stands at first with one out. Hard on the ground towards short. And that's through for a hit. And he certainly has been no mystery to solve thus far. And sooner or later, they might need to get someone else in there just to get out of the first. At the plate now, Dylan Carlson. And a double steal try here. And that's through into right field for a base hit. The runner from second crosses the plate.
Dan, you know what? You like to see that from an offense. When you have a guy in scoring position, there's no sense in waiting around. He saw a pitch he liked right there, and he went after it.
He did, D-Row, and I think that's what most hitters do. They come up with guys on base that they can potentially drive in. They're looking for a pitch to hit, and he didn't wait around and got that bat hit started.
And now, Edmundo Sosa, three across so far in the inning, and another two out there on base.
Yeah, Matt, and this inning's really starting to get away from them on the defensive side of the ball. Stranding the rest of those guys out here feels absolutely essential for them at this point.
Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch. As he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0.
Hey, this is a spot as a pitcher right now you want to get a little bit greedy. Ideally, it'd be to roll up a two ball. At worst, try to get yourself a strikeout.
The 1-0. Two balls and a strike.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Now the 2-1. Hit hard on the ground towards second. There's Baez. One there. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. So three runs on five hits. No errors. And a runner left. On now to the bottom of inning number one. It's the Cardinals 3. The Mets coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Adam Wainwright gets the start for St. Louis in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Their ball club is going to have to keep a close eye on this one. This guy's nearing 200 innings on the season, and that's a lot of innings. A guy that takes the ball every 5 days. I'm sure they're going to watch to see if there are any signs of him tiring early in this one.
And now here is Jonathan Villar. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And the pitch. Nope. The 1-0.
Oh, that's cool.
Hit on the ground toward the left. Oh, and it sailed right over his head at first.
Man, this one is hard to figure. Makes the play on the ball, and the transfer looked good. Then he just sails this thing way over the first baseman's head into the stands. Bad news, it's an E5. The good news, some fan just snagged a souvenir.
And that'll bring in the switch-hitting Francisco Lindor. As he'll take a look at ball one. The average not quite where he wants it, down in the 220s. 17 home runs to go along with 52 RBIs. The 1-0 is taken, strike one.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
Oh, right back to him on the mound. And an unproductive at-bat that time as the runner holds at second with one away now.
The right fielder, Michael.
For the moment here in Flushing Meadows, let's meet the Mets. What's this club going to need to focus on this evening, Mark?
Well, Matty, the defense better be on its toes today because this lineup likes to put the ball in play. A lot of guys from 1 through 9, good barrel awareness, put the ball in play, pass the baton to the next guy, keep the defense on their toes.
Into the box, Michael Conforto, as Wainwright's able to jump ahead of him here with strike one. And it's fouled away. He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Runner at second here with one man out. Conforto behind, a ball and two strikes. To third, gloved by Arenado, in time to first, and there are two away. So here's Pete Alonso, and as you can see, he's had some troubles here in his own ballpark. That's something he'll look to improve upon in this one. Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
The 1-0 home is taken for ball two.
If you're going to have any chance against a good pitcher, you got to find yourself in some great counts, and he's certainly worked himself into a nice 2-0 count right here.
Three and oh now.
Not a good spot to be in right now. A pitcher's falling behind in the count with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
VR stands at second with two gone. He loses him on ball four.
That is fifth. The second baseman.
Next up from New York, Javier Baez.
Oh, yeah.
Now here's the first offering. Off the plate and low here, ball one. Fouled off. Two down, runners at first and second. Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez.
Boy, this hole he's digging on the mound is all his doing. If you can't throw strikes, you're not going to be out there very long.
Swing and a miss, strike two.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
This is hit high in the air out toward left center. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. Two left for the Mets. They trail it here 3-0. Now into the box is Harrison Bader, and the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood inning. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. Pilar has it, and it's a quick out number one.
Batting none, the pitcher, number 50, Adam Wainwright.
So here now is the pitcher, Adam Wainwright. Here's the first pitch. And he takes ball one. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1. Cardinals pitcher up there with a 1-2 count. Here comes the 1-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
The 2-2 is laid off and the count runs full.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Swing and a little blooper to center. Pilar moving in, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Tommy Edman. Second appearance here. He grounded out to start the ball game. First pitch on the way. No balls and one strike. Set to deliver the 0-1.
Hey, I got to really commend this pitcher right here. Was able to regroup in between innings. Something happened in the dugout because he's on point coming out for the second.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2. A check swing, and he went around, says the home plate umpire. Pretty forceful about it, too. And the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. But they lead it 3-0. Last half of the second set to go. And standing in the outfielder, Jeff McNeil.
Number six.
First pitch coming from Wainwright. Swing and a line drive. But this is foul for the first strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder. He's there and records the first out. Do you still
cry the end of my batting seven, the center fielder, Kevin Bozar.
Now one down with the bases empty, and that'll bring up a man who's a human highlight reel defensively, Kevin Pillar. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. Pillar stands at an even 6 feet tall, a right-handed batter and thrower. He's a 9-year Major League vet. Lays off the sinker here, a ball and a strike. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw on to first, and Wainwright has it working now. Two away. So next to bat will be James McCann, and he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. A ball and no strikes. Hit Wheatley back to the mound. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. Mets go down 1-2-3. They trail in this one 3-0. Top of the third set to get underway, and set to go is the veteran first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. Here it comes.
I guess the game plan from the offensive standpoint today coming into this one was they were going to work the counts. They've been super patient at the plate in the early goings of this game, and they've got the lead looking for more.
Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
Man, there's just no excuse for a middle infielder to make a play like that, especially your shortstop. Looked like a routine play, but for some reason, he just pulled the first baseman off the bag. It happens, but you'd never want to give a team extra outs.
Stepping in now, Tyler O'Neill, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. 1-for-1 as he reached base with a double his first time up. Started the breaking ball far too inside that time, laid off for ball one.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
The 1-1 home.
Hey, after the double in his first at bat, looks like he's trying to pitch around this guy a little bit.
The 2-1. 2-2 the count. Goldschmidt aboard here at first with nobody out. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside. 3-2.
I don't know if that was a great take or he got fooled. He's certainly trying to play it off like he knew what was coming. You could bet he'd be on alert for that curveball again.
This is in the air out to straightaway center. Pillar will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. And that'll bring in Nolan Arenado, looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat. He's set and the pitch. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Boy, in a mid-80s fastball that time, but it's a called strike 1-1.
That's a real nice location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
High in the air out to center field. Pilar is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina. He singled in his first AB. From the belt, the pitch. Starts him out with a slider for a strike.
Hey, he's done an amazing job of settling down. Two innings ago, I thought they were going to run him out of here. But now he's close to posting two shutout innings as a response.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Ball one.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. He'll try again, 1-2. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. One left for the Cardinals. They lead it 3-0. Bottom of the third now, and set to stand in as the veteran pitcher, Rich Hill.
No pitcher, Rich Hill.
First pitch coming, here it is.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence, he's got great body language on the mound, he's got fastball command, and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Behind 0-2 now. Grounded back up the middle. And a good throw gets him, one gone. Now back to the top of the Mets order, digging in, Jonathan Villar. 0-1 here in the early going. Here's the first pitch. On the year, Villar brings a batting average just a little over the 250 mark. Mets are still looking for their first hit of the ball game. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Lifted in the air out to right. Long run for the right fielder. He makes the running play. Two down. Two down, no one on base. That'll bring up the switch hitting shortstop and perennial MVP candidate Francisco Lindor. First pitch of the AB now. And Wainwright able to get ahead with the breaking pitch for strike one.
Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
The windup and the 0-1. A little bit low that time, maybe outside as well. Bases are empty here with two men out. And this is low, ball two. 2-1. A three ball, one strike count to the Mets shortstop.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Well, this will be pulled in out there at second base, and that'll be that. Down in order go the Mets. Still down 3-0.
Yeah. Who that in the whip? Yeah, you know it's me. You can't stop my shine. I'm just doing me. Yeah, I'ma take a pick for them all to see.
Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cardinals to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And he was very pleased with how little they're swinging and missing right now. Looking at the advanced data, our researchers found that about 9 of 10 swings are resulting in some sort of contact today, which is well above Major League average. The result has been a lot of balls in play, a lot of hits, and solid run production, guys.
Thank you, Heidi. All set for the start of the fourth. And digging in is the outfielder, Dylan Carlson. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he'll look at a fastball that doesn't miss by a whole lot. It's 1-0. Smoke toward the hole. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
The batter, the shortstop, Edmundo Sosa.
In now, Edmundo Sosa, as he'll take a called strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. That misses to the Cardinal shortstop, and it's even at 1-1. Carlson on at first, nobody out. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way.
As a pitcher right there, do not be surprised if he throws the same exact pitch. He was lucky to foul that one off.
And that one got a piece of him.
Well, as a pitcher, you never want to hit a guy, but he's been struggling early, and the hitters have owned the inside part of the plate, so maybe this will help him reclaim the inner half and start to become more effective. Has to command it in there, though.
Next to dig in, Harrison Bader. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. From the belt, kicks and deals. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Here it comes, 0-2. Three runs, six hits. One error for the Cardinals to this point. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. There's a breaking ball that couldn't quite catch the inside.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
The 2-2. Making him work out there. The ninth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Donnie finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a nine-pitch at-bat.
That job tying him up inside on that strikeout pitch, it wasn't even in the strike zone, but with the hitter protecting with two strikes, that's the kind of pitch you can get him to offer at, and he's probably not going to do much with it when he does make contact.
Into the box now, Adam Wainwright. As the first pitch here is a bit high, it's ball one. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 1-0 is taken high above the zone.
And this guy can hit a little bit too, so you just can't lay one in there 2-0.
And a very low strike there. Trying to speed up the game, perhaps. It's 2-1. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
If I'm in the box right now, I'm coming unglued. He is going to throw something over the heart of the plate.
The 3-1 pitch. Drilled on the ground to short. And that's through, a base hit. Carlson rounds the corner and is headed home. He'll score easily as they move on top 4-0.
Boy, Dero, you have to be licking your chops sitting in a 3-1 count. You get a fastball, he gets it and doesn't miss it.
Yeah, Dan, that's what you strive for. Find count leverage situations where you can be aggressive. Process of elimination tells you he's got to come fastball or something over the heart of the plate, and he didn't miss it.
Hep brings in Tommy Edmund as he swings and hits a laser to right. And a base hit, and that'll get the run in from third. The relay throw, and this will get in there too late. He's in there at third.
There's no way to sugarcoat it. It's been pretty bad for 3 1/3 innings so far. That's the 8th hit he's given up. And if he doesn't get his mind straight, he's going to be heading to the showers early.
Now here comes the Mets skipper on his way toward the mound. And that's going to be all for our starter, Rich Hill. So as he leaves, I would imagine these fans would not be much pleased with his performance here this evening, as he certainly was not sharp. Trevor May answers the call from the pen here in the fourth, as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. Here's Paul Goldschmidt now, as the first pitch misses to him. It's ball one. He's 1-for-2 in this one. The 1-0. A bouncer to the left side. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
That grounder was hard hit, and sometimes the runner at third will have to hold on a ball like that, but he was off on contact, and they opted to take the out at first instead.
Now to the plate, here is Tyler O'Neill. He's 1-for-2 with an RBI double back in the first inning of this one. Has a look, now the pitch.
When you're down 6 on the mound, you got to at least throw strikes here.
Two and oh pitch on the way. Called a strike on the inside part of the plate. 2-1.
Nasty 2-0 slider right there for a strike. No shame in tipping your hat.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Ground ball right side, fielded cleanly, and the throw just does beat him at the bag, so the side is retired. So 3 runs on 3 hits, no errors, and a man left. On now to the bottom half of inning number 4. Cards lead it 6-0. Ready now is Michael Conforto. D-Row down 6 already in the early part of this ball game. What's the mentality for them as they try to work their way back?
You know what, Matty? This is where you take some prideful ABs. I've been down 6 before, and I've come back from even further down than that in some big ball games. You have to find a way to just relax and start piecing some good ABs back to back. Hey, with this big a lead, you have to just pound the zone and force this team to get aggressive in the box.
The 1-0 home. Hit sharply on the ground. That's a hit, the first of the game for the Mets.
He's been cold. Batting average fell below 230, but that knock might have put him in a positive frame of mind. Hopefully that's the start of something big.
Oh, what a goal.
Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. The numbers coming in. He's at 255, 32 home runs, and an even 80 RBIs. And it's quickly 0-2. Curveball, but he can't get him to chase it. 1-2.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
Count still at 1-2. Conforto gets his lead at first, nobody out. Ball two.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
And a good curveball gets him swinging for out number one.
That's just a great pitch, both on the call from the catcher and the execution. If he hits it, there's a good chance it turns into a double play ball, but it's also a spot that's going to get a lot of whiffs, too. That's excellent pitching.
And that brings up Javi Baez, as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Ready with the 0-1. Swing and a screamer, but this one's not going to stay fair.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting a good pitch to hit are way worse.
And this one's in the dirt. Good job there as the count goes to 1-2. From the stretch. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now. Two and two now to Baez. Hit hard down the line. And that's through for a base hit. Make him 1-for-2 in this one. The tag, and they got him at third. What a throw.
Hey, I love to be aggressive on the base pass, certainly when you're watching the play. That runner saw that baseball right in front of him. The whole play transpired right in front of him, and he felt he could get to third base, then he better get there. Can't be thrown out in that situation.
So here's Jeff McNeil, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Smoke toward third. Arenado's got it. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. So they pick up no runs on two base hits, no errors, and one man left on. We played four full. The Cardinals are out in front, 6-0. And now the Cardinals' number four hitter, Nolan Arenado. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
As he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Well, he was definitely struggling coming into this one, but I think we could say that cold streak is officially over. That's his second hit of the game, and it goes for extra bases. We'll see now if this game proves to be a huge turning point for him.
To the plate now, Yadier Molina. Line drive to left. There to make the catch is McNeil, and there's one away. And he's safe. Now next to hit is Dylan Carlson. A couple of singles to his credit thus far. First pitch of the AB now. And he'll watch one miss up and away for a ball, 1-0.
Everyone in the ballpark knows what the pitcher's intentions are in this situation. Great job at the plate to lay off a tough pitch in a good spot.
1-0 count, here it is. And that's inside and a bit low anyways. It's 2-0.
And how about the uncommon patience for the rookie in a big spot right here? These have been some tough pitches to lay off.
2-1 after the foul ball there. One out and a runner on third. Skied down the left field line. Left fielder is on the move. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And he will get in to score, and it's a run batted in on the sacrifice fly. Next, it'll be Edmundo Sosa. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch. First pitch of the AB on its way. Fly ball out toward left center field. And what an effort on the running play to end the inning. So one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on base. Home half of the fifth coming up. The Cardinals lead it 7-0. You asked for it. About to go no string out. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with the Mets manager to discuss his thoughts on his club's offense so far, and he told me the quality of their swings needs to improve as the game moves forward. He said they're searching for ways to drive the ball with some authority because it's just not happening for them today. They haven't gotten an extra base hit yet, so it's been a real struggle getting guys into scoring position. But the key, he said, is not to panic. Sometimes you just have to fight through the downturns and keep your focus and energy high.
Way to go.
All right, thanks, Heidi. At the plate now is Kevin Pillar. He leads off in the bottom of the fifth as they look to break through on the scoreboard for the first time in this one.
Yeah, no doubt about it. You can tell in between innings the veterans in that dugout going up and down the line, trying to keep this lineup from getting super frustrated. They just have to find a way to piece it together, maybe pass the baton, get some wheels in motion, maybe get aggressive on the base paths if they can get somebody on.
The 1-0. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Look into Molina, now the 1-1. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike. Big rip at the curveball, but he comes up empty, and it's even at 2-2.
Woo, not a spot you expect a curveball. He's lucky he missed because that's the kind of pitch that gets hit out of the ballpark.
Still 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Down the left field line and deep. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Is looked at and the count moves full.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch.
I know the fans love the souvenirs, but the battle between the pitcher and batter right here is what makes the game great.
And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway.
And that at bat will put a smile on any manager's face. The pitch total of the opposing pitcher just keeps going higher and higher, and he still couldn't put him away. So this inning is off to a good start for the guys carrying the sticks.
Now at the plate is James McCann. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
First pitch coming from Wainwright. Weak grounder down the line at third. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Has a look. Now the pitch. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. Oh, and two. Here it comes. A bouncer to the left side. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out. J.D. Davis will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. From the stretch. Yes, he pops the first pitch foul behind the plate. And he's got that batting lineup near the 300 mark entering play. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Breaking ball is swung on and bounced to short. And there's out number two. Now at the plate, here is Jonathan Villar. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here's the first pitch to him. Sinker's in there. No balls and a strike. Called strike 0-2.
He hasn't thrown that pitch much all game. I got to believe as an offense, you just got to throw that pitch away and move on to the next one.
Hit in the air to left. O'Neill waits on it. And that will end the inning. Mets strand one. They need to get something cooking here. It's 7-0. Trevor Williams gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Harrison Bader. And now the first pitch. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Two balls and no strikes to the Cardinals center fielder.
Well, that's another great hitting count here on 2-0. It's no wonder why they're up seven.
Now the pitch. Hit hard back up the middle. Baez fields it cleanly. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
The pitcher, number 50.
Next to hit will be the pitcher, Adam Wainwright, getting to hit for himself here, largely due to the big cushion he's got to work with. First pitch on the way. Fastball in there for a called strike. And it looks now like a right-hander's begun to get loose in the Mets bullpen. Bases are empty, one man out. No plate discipline that time, and he's in the hole now, 0-2. High and deep to right center. On the move is Pilar. He gets there, and that's the second out.
The batter number.
So two gone now in the St. Louis half of the sixth, and that'll bring in Tommy Edman. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. There's a fastball called for a strike on the inside corner. Fouled away. high in the air down the right field line. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Down in order go the Cardinals, but they're still in control, 7-0.
Leading up for the Mets, the shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
First offering, Francisco Lindor is at the plate as he looks at ball one. And he fouls this one off. The 1-1 is a sinker that misses for a ball. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And he is into second base with a leadoff double.
When you're struggling as a team to put the ball in play, every base hit is welcome, but a double will really help wake everyone up. That's just their third hit of the game, but it's a good one.
At the plate, Michael Conforto. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. The 1-0 home. Lindor stands at second with no outs. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Here comes the 1-2. Softly hit toward the hole. Scooped up. And that's the first out.
Now batting.
And next will be the Mets cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. Struck out in his last trip to the plate. First pitch of the AB on its way as he'll take a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1.
You could tell this guy's got great feel for all his stuff right now. To break out that nasty hammer right there, this guy's on point.
And boy, big problems here to start this at bat. It's 0-2 now.
Real ugly 0-1 swing there. As a pitcher, you've got to be hunting for the strikeout knowing you have this guy way off balance.
He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch.
Wow, kind of an interesting pitch call there. The batter flailed at the pitch away on the previous one, so you'd think you'd go right back there, but instead they decided to come in. Make him prove he can adjust before you do.
Here comes the 1-2. Still a ball and two strikes. No runs, three hits. One error in the game for the Mets thus far. Misses, ball two. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Good battle, count remains full.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt, but he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
And he misses with one here. It's ball four. So that'll at least bring the double play into the conversation with runners at the corners and one away.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of the zone. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
Stepping in next, Javier Baez, and their runners at the corners now. Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two. With two strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Good time to try to put the ball down in the strike zone. You can either get a strikeout or a potential double play ball.
Ready on 0-2. Well off the inside that time as the sinker misses for a ball. And he's jammed a bit on that one, but he's able to foul it off to the right to stay alive. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here. Broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. Reined in to second for one, but one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
Looked like that might be an inning-ending double play off the bat, but that was some great hustle to beat the throw at first. Keeps the inning alive, and more importantly, he gets an RBI because of it.
Jeff McNeil will be the next to take a turn. He'll swing and lift a ball foul off to the left and out of play. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Set to deliver the 0-1. On the ground up the middle. That's through and he's got his first base hit. He's 1 for 3.
You know, D-Row, the old school thinking sometimes is when you're going through a bad streak like this guy, any way you can get out, a little jam shot, even though it wasn't pretty, maybe this could get this guy finally going.
Yeah, I can't tell you how good that had to feel right there. There's moments where you slap that donut off your bat, you don't even want to walk to home plate. You're scuffling so bad.
Standing in now, Kevin Pillar. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. And with just 5 2/3 innings under his belt, he's about to hit the century mark in his pitch count now.
Yeah, Matty V, and the way baseball is played these days, it's about 6 innings or 100 heaves, and you're pretty much looking for that bullpen. And D-Row right now, this guy's pretty vulnerable right now at this game.
Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove, but they'll still manage to get the out on the force, and with that fine play, the inning comes to an end. The Mets played a run on a couple of hits. 7th inning coming up. It's the Cardinals 7 and the Mets 1. And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt. He's working on a 1 for 3 thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. As he takes a called strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
Yeah, that looked like an auto take right there, just trying to measure up this pitcher's stuff.
The windup and the 0-1. Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
What I like about that strikeout, guys, is that he came back with a fastball on 2-2. He was heading to count 0-2 earlier, but instead of continuing to nibble a little bit, he decided to get aggressive again and to challenge with his hard stuff.
Into the box, Tyler O'Neill, as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. The 1-0. misses for the second ball.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Skied into straightaway right. Long run for the right fielder. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now batting.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Nolan Arenado. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, it's been an offensive explosion for him today. There's a fight at the bat rack. Everyone seems to be putting barrel on baseball in this lineup.
Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that's in there. Base hit. Running hard. He's digging for second. And he is in to second with a double, his third hit of the night.
When it left his bat, I thought it might squirt foul, but it hugged the line and found its way into the corner. Thought it might be a little bit closer play at second, but he cruised in there with relative ease.
So now to the plate, Yadier Molina, as the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here. A ball and no strikes, here it is.
With two outs and a base open, I don't think he's going to see anything of the hit in this at bat. Not much reason for it.
Two balls and a strike to Molina.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
The 2-1 home. Their count now at 2-2. From the stretch, and an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that the side is retired. Two out double, left stranded. Back with more on this Monday night after this. Last half of the seventh here, and now it'll be the catcher, James McCann.
The catcher, James.
First pitch of the AB now.
Probably a designed take right there. They need base runners, so they're going to make him try to bring the ball in the strike zone.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Man, this guy's really pitched well so far, attacking the strike zone, and he's really kept these hitters off balance.
Here it comes on nothing and two. Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. And the throw is there to record the first out. Luis Guillorme steps into the on-deck circle now, looking to start something here with one gone in the inning. First pitch of the AB now. As he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. Hit on the ground to short. And very quickly there, they're two gone to start the inning. Now at the plate, Jonathan Villar, fourth trip to the plate now, and he's hitless to this point.
Yeah, he and his teammates have really been shut down by some very good pitching in this one. Been fun for a guy like me to watch.
Ready to deliver, here comes the first pitch. Curveball taken for a strike on the inside.
Hey, this guy's been throwing a gem so far. We're moving on later into this game, and he's right at about league average for first pitch strikes.
And it's fouled away. Two out, nobody on. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Mets go down 1-2-3. They're down 7-1. Tyler McGill enters now in a mop-up role as he'll try to keep the deficit right where it is. Ready to begin the eighth, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Dylan Carlson. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Lifted the other way down the left field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Comes set with the 0-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
Chopper to short. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Next to stand in is Edmundo Sosa, flew out last time up.
And with his speed, he's one of those rare guys who you'd actually like to see keep the ball on the ground. You can't beat out a fly ball in this game.
Back up the middle, and that'll get on through into center, and he's got himself a one-out hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
So that'll bring in Harrison Bader. He grounded out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
He's set. Here it comes.
Yep, that ball went
McGill,
out.
A right-hander who goes 6'7" tall. This is his first year at the big league level. That one will get out of play, and the count evens up at 1-1.
This is a tough guy to turn two on. It's got to be hit hard. If you're an infielder, you've got to catch it and get rid of it quickly.
Sosa, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. From the belt, the pitch.
Ball two. Two balls, two strikes.
And oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning. And with strike three recorded there, he's notched his first career major league strikeout.
Well, Matt, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to end up being a solid one. All the best pitchers at this level have at least one pitch that they can go into in tough situations. So we'll see if he becomes one of those guys as his career goes along.
Lars Nootbaar is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. Batting average down in the low 210s. 3 homers, 10 RBIs. The 1-0.
You thank your lucky stars when you get a chance to hit behind a guy with as much speed as he has on first base. The entire defense is on guard, and you know probably there's a fastball coming.
Here comes the 2-0 pitch. Fouled off. A runner on first with two away.
Ball
tough one to call there, but it's ruled just above the zone. Tommy Edman would be next. Throw over to first, and the runner back in standing. The 3-1 pulled high in the air out to right field. Conforto finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Cards leave one. They're on top 7-1. Andrew Miller is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Francisco Lindor will be the first one to greet him because he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here.
Francisco Lindor.
He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And a good fastball there, but this just misses the zone for ball one. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now. Two and one now. The pitch. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll hit off the wall in left center. The relay, but he'll be in there with a double.
Sometimes when a reliever comes in a game, he wants to get that first strike so bad that he serves one up, and that's exactly what happens here. The first batter he faces just rockets one off the wall, and now he's got to worry about another base hit, potentially bringing home a run.
Stepping in now, Michael Conforto, as the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. He bounced out last time up. Now the 1-0.
That's in, ball two.
Cardinals get the bullpen started here as a right-hander's up and warming. Into the corner and slicing foul. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted high and deep. Out of here, into the visitor's bullpen. Michael Conforto connects for a two-run home run. 12 home runs for him now thus far, as it's now a 7-3 game.
This is the matchup you'd like as a pitcher, right? Lefty on left, but sometimes you don't win all of the battles. Gave this guy a pitch to hit, and he made him pay for it.
First baseman.
Into the box now, Pete Alonso. Let's watch a sinker here that misses. It's ball one. It was a walk in his last trip. That's wide, 2-0. And And now a pitch on the way. Swing and a ball hit on the ground.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
It's clear he just hasn't been able to find any rhythm out there. Pretty much unable to hit any of his spots, and now he's at 3-1, and he's put him into another great hitting count.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And he takes ball four again. And they clearly just don't want any part of him in this one.
And don't forget, he gave up a long ball earlier in this inning, so you can understand why he wasn't too aggressive with him there. When he got him to 3-1, he wasn't too anxious to challenge him.
Here's Javier Baez. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one.
He struggled a bit coming out of the bullpen here, so he needed that strike. Maybe it settles him down a little bit.
In the dirt here. Good job keeping it close as the count goes to 1-1. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1. Two and two.
That swing had one purpose, and that was to put the ball over the wall. I guess he doesn't have much to lose with his team down this many at this point in the game.
Fastball just missed above the zone. Jeff McNeil waits on deck. Now the 3-2 pitch. Full count still. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. That was a nasty looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. The classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
At the plate, Jeff McNeil, as he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. And he looks at a slider in there, 1-1.
That's three straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well a fourth time. I'd be looking heater.
There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone. All even now, 2-2. Alonso leads off first with one away. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two. Do you still cry? And stepping in, Kevin Pillar. Grounded out in his last at-bat. First delivery to him. A ball and no strikes.
Hey, this pitcher's going to have to step off the mound right here and refocus. Take a deep breath, something. Can't keep falling behind and creating traffic. It puts everybody on edge, not only himself, his defense, and especially his manager.
The 1-1. Is a fastball that misses.
I got 2-1 to count.
Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Again, another foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. He is high and outside for a ball.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
The slider freezes him at the plate. A called third strike, and the inning comes to a close. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run home run. On to the ninth inning from Citi Field. It's now 7-3. All set for the start of the inning, and that'll bring in Tommy Edman.
The second baseman, Tommy Edman.
First pitch on the way. The 1-0. A swing and a miss, strike one.
Hey, guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight where it's super cold out, if you don't get to head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. On deck, the powerful right-handed bat of Paul Goldschmidt. There's the good fastball, and he can't catch up. 3-2.
Okay, if you're in this lineup right here, game on, boys. I know he's got power stuff, but if he's going to come middle of the plate, you better be ready to pull the trigger.
Swing and a line drive. And that is in the left field, so the leadoff man's aboard to kick off the ninth.
He doubled up on the heater right there. First one, he blew right by him. Second one, timing was on point, and he was able to get a hit.
At the plate now, Paul Goldschmidt, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day.
Here we go, guys. Come on.
Now it's 2-0.
He's going to have a talk with the umpire after this half inning, because if he's not going to get those calls, he's got to come a little bit more over the heart of the plate. And that usually means damage done.
2-1.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Runners on the move for second. And this will be fouled away. Oh, and there's the good curveball as he set down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
Into the box, Tyler O'Neill, as he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. He's got one hit in four at-bats. A 1 count, here's the pitch. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Runner at first here, one man out. Throw over to the bag, and a dive, but he's back in there. And again a throw, a dive, but he's back. Three and one to the Cardinals left fielder.
We all know this guy is a great hitter. In a 3-1 count, this is just what he's looking for. He loves to hit when the count's in his favor like this.
And the count will be full.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
3-2 pitch. Rip down the line, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. Two down. That's back-to-back strikeouts now as they've been unable to advance that leadoff single into scoring position.
Yeah, clearly no problems working out of the stretch right now, Matt. He's taking control this inning after giving up that hit. Now we'll see if he can finish it off strong as well.
Digging in next, Nolan Arenado. Three hits, including a pair of doubles for him thus far. Prior to the at-bat, a check on first. And the runner back. From the belt, kicks and deals as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
He'll take that first pitch strike all day long. If they're going to take 0-0, he's going to pound that zone and get ahead. Much more susceptible down 0-1 than 1-0.
In the dirt, and now let's see. Throw is up the line as it gets away. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder, but a foul ball, one and two now. From the belt, kicks and deals. Breaking ball misses the corner, two balls and two strikes. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, three and two.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Popped him up. McCann moving to his left, and he makes the play to end the inning. One left for the Cardinals. They hang on to a 7-3 lead. Giovanni Gallegos takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And that'll bring in the veteran catcher, James McCann. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Just off the outside as he can't catch the corner. Gallegos has racked up over 70 innings on the mound and logged in with an ERA in the low threes. And 2-0 as this one's taken low. Now the pitch. And here's a fastball for a strike. 2-1 now. The pitch. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt him over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. Cardinals are into their bullpen now, as there are the final numbers for their starter. He was on point from the get-go this evening.
Matty V, really a solid performance. Seven strong innings pitched, in line for the win. Needs some help for the bullpen to close this one out.
Let's go, Dominic Smith is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. One out, nobody on. Swing and a line drive, but a foul ball, one and one.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
The 1-2 runs a bit inside for a ball.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
It'd be great right here if he was able to work himself on base. You got the leadoff hitter on deck, and you know the middle of the order's coming up right behind him.
And he lays off, ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Third base, number one, Jonathan.
Stepping in once again is Jonathan Villar, 0 for 4 with a strikeout thus far. Ready to deal, here comes the first pitch. Well, you'd credit Adam Wainwright with the victory, barring any late turnaround here. 1-0 count, here it is. That misses, 2-0. Lifted the other way to left center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets there, and that's the second out. A long way to go to make that running catch, and here it is again with the show track numbers. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 110 feet to finally bring it in. No doubt in efforts his teammates are appreciative of. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Smith leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Well off the plate with the change of pace, that's ball two. And there's ball three on a breaking ball that misses away. Michael Conforto would be next. Here it is, the 3-0. Fastball too low, and that's ball four.
That is just a great at-bat there. When you're down late, you need base runners any way you can get them, and that never-say-die mentality could be the difference. We'll see how it plays out.
Alex Reyes takes over on the mound now as he'll try to get the final out of the ballgame here and pick up a save. And now in the box, Michael Conforto. And these guys are making a little push here. You have to like the effort despite the odds.
Yeah, you really do, Matt. Look, they still have a significant hill to climb, but hey, they string a couple of hits together here, and all of a sudden, this thing feels doable.
Here's the first pitch. As he'll take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
He's set. Here's the 0-1. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed, and now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Woo! Up and in.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Drilled to the right side. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And a good throw will wind up holding that runner at third, so the bases become loaded now with two gone.
And that fires me up right there. What a clutch AB, a two-out single to get the tying run to the plate. That's all you can ask for.
So now to the plate, Pete Alonso. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. And it's a strange line developing for him in this one. He's been walked several times. A ball and a strike to the Mets first baseman. Bases are loaded here, two down. Taking called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight.
Sometimes you can get away with a pitch in that location when you're running it up there that hard, but not...
Ah, and he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate, but could not cash in.
Man, they've already put the all-time winning streak record in their rearview mirrors. But with every win, it gets further and further away. We could say this now, this is one of the greatest teams in the history of baseball.
And tonight's final, 7-3. St. Louis jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Adam Wainwright wins his 17th game of the season. Rich Hill struggled and gets the loss after giving up 6 earned. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
Tonight, first for the victorious St. Louis Cardinals, 7 runs on 12 hits, 1 error, they left 7 men on base. For the Mets, 3 runs on 7 hits, 2 errors, they left 10 men on base. The winning pitcher is Adam Wainwright. His record now is 17-7.
One shot is never enough. I just wipe
the loss goes to Rich Hill. He falls to 6-8. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 21 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.